Yesterday, Elon Musk responded to Donald Trump's attacks that came from his rally last Sunday. And when Elon Musk did that, I predicted on the pre-show, dear God, Donald Trump is going to lose it. And he has in fact lost it. Truthing, when Elon Musk came to the White House asking me for help on all of his many subsidized projects, whether it's electric cars that don't drive long enough, driverless cars that crash, or rocket ships to nowhere, without which subsidies he'd be worthless, and telling me how he was a big Trump fan and Republican, I could have said, drop to your knees and beg, and he would have done it. That is obviously not founded in truth, at least if you believe Elon Musk. He never said that he voted for Trump or whatever, but that's fairly brutal. Almost as brutal as, can we return to that graphic for one sec? Now, bearing in mind that this screenshot was taken 22 minutes after it was truth, how much does it burn Donald Trump that 22 minutes after he puts something on his social media platform, it can have 524 retruths? That's got to sting after the Twitter days. But anyway, he sent that out and he had more to say. But first, Elon Musk responded to that with maybe the first funny thing Elon Musk has ever done in his life, which is the Simpsons man yells at cloud meme to Donald Trump. But there was more. Donald Trump goes on to say, P.S. Why was Elon allowed to break the $15 million stock purchase barrier on Twitter without any reporting? That is a very serious breach. Have fun, Elon and Jack. Go to it. So implying that he should be investigated for, I guess, one of the many crimes that Elon Musk has clearly committed in the financial world. Now Elon should focus on getting himself out of the Twitter mess because he could owe $44 billion for something that's perhaps worthless. Also, lots of competition for electric cars. And all of that accompanied with this photo of Elon Musk standing weirdly at attention in an unbalanced photo. I don't know why they took it that way. But Trump demonstrates in those that he doesn't seem to understand the stakes in the whole Twitter thing. But he's mocking Elon Musk for basically everything at this point. He didn't get into his divorces, I guess. I don't know. Maybe that's glass houses, but he's really coming at him, Brett.
I love this so much. This makes me so happy. It makes me think of the phrase like, fight. Never interrupt your enemy when he's making a mistake.
Yeah.
You know, recoined by Kanye. I'm gonna let you finish. Mm-hmm. I love to watch it. This is like when you, it's like watching Godzilla versus King Kong, but not the new ones with the cool CGI, like the old ones where it's obviously like a man in a rubber suit that like when they punch each other, there's like a dent and it stays dented until it pops out. Like these two galactic morons are yelling at each other and I'm fine with it. And Elon Musk, what he's trying to do is, both of them are liars. Both of them are BS artists. Both of them have benefited insanely while trying to be like the bannerman of this populist right wing movement. Both are heirs to immense fortunes and beneficiaries of giant government bailout programs, whether it's Tesla getting subsidized or Trump and Chapter 11 being like the dog-eared page in his manual.
Yeah, 100%. No, you love to see it. They can wrestle with each other until they both fall into the fires of Mount Doom for all that I care. But more importantly, that is what they're gonna do. Both of them could just go back to their billionaire lives and be perfectly happy, but both of them share something fundamentally beyond just what Brett said, which is all true, they're BS artists and all that, is that they are so desperate to be popular, to be loved. They cannot accept the other getting the last word or one-upping them, because they are both nothing but a need for attention and admiration. And so every time there's an elevation, I've watched Peaky Blinders. I know where this goes, so stay tuned. Anyway, thank you everyone who's been watching this shorter show. For the full show though, don't go anywhere. We'll be back in a few. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.